Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you doing this fine day? Me? I am wondering if you're a little bit pissed off at Evernote for changing the rules. I mean, changing their pricing plan. I think that is exactly what we should explore today on Dotto Tech. If you're a longtime viewer of this channel, you know I post a lot about Evernote. We have, in fact, a course on using Evernote, so it's a big part of our business. So I notice everything that goes on in the Evernote world. So, of course, a change in pricing of Evernote is of paramount importance to me and to many of you in my community. So I thought we'd spend a few minutes and take a look at Evernote's new pricing, and just so that we can all understand exactly where we sit. And I think the biggest change in Evernote's pricing in their free basic service is the fact that they are now limiting the number of devices that you can sync at any one particular time. And this is a big deal. This changes things profoundly for a lot of Evernote users. Because one of the keys of using Evernote to collect all of your information and have all of your data stored in one place is the fact that you can then access that data wherever you are and whenever you are from any of your devices. That was before. Today, you can access your information, if you're on the free plan, from two devices. And actually, that's a bit of a misnomer, because through the web, we can actually access it through more devices. But I'll talk about that more in a minute. But so the biggest change now for all of us is in this free basic plan is you still have 60 megabytes of data that you can upload. It's still free for all of your notes and storing all of your content online and on multiple devices, but it's only two devices. So those of you who have a computer and an iPhone or an Android phone, or a computer and an iPad or a tablet, those are the only two devices that you can use. So what happens if you have three devices that you want? Say you have a computer, a tablet, and a phone. What are we going to do? Well, for those people, what I'd suggest is you use the Evernote web version on your computer. I'm just going to sign into my web version here. And on your computer, the web version is actually pretty robust, and it does most of what you need. The reason that I would recommend going this route, if you have multiple devices and you want to stay in the same plan, is the access to the camera and the other media features in your mobile devices, especially on your phone, are far more valuable to you. Using the Evernote web clipper and using the web version of the Evernote, you can do most of what you need to do within Evernote just on the web, so it doesn't use up one of your devices. Now, how do you find out how many devices you have enrolled in Evernote right now? Well, you can do it from all of your different devices in different ways. Within the web version here, we can just go in Account settings by clicking on the bottom here and then clicking on settings. And within our settings here, we can see a device tab. That device tab will then tell us how many devices we have connected. And I actually have 10 devices here. Now, I'm not going to apologize for this, because since they changed this now to only allowing two, it's the first time I've ever thought about how many devices I have hooked up. And the reason I have so many devices registered is I use a whole bunch of different devices when I'm testing things out. So many of these different devices are tools or computers or devices that I have been testing Evernote on or test using. But all you have to do if you want to make a change is go through and revoke access to any of them, and they will be removed from your device menu. So you see I'm removing several devices. This same menu you can access on your mobile device. Actually, let's just show it to you on the smartphone, because we might as well. Let's go into Evernote on our smartphone. And within Evernote on our smartphone, we can go into under the gear icon right there, the gear icon, which takes us into all of our settings. We go into the My Account tab is where it is. And there we see the number of devices, and mine's already updated. See, my smartphone's already updated to just 8 devices now. But really, I only use 4. I use my Android phone, my iPhone, my Macs, my desktop Mac, and my mobile Mac, my MacBook Pro. So those are the only devices that I really need to have connected. So I'm going to need 4. That's a big decision point for you. If you're going to stay with the basic version, you're going to have to reduce down to 2 devices, or you're going to have to upgrade to the more premium versions. Now, what do you get for more money? And don't freak out by looking at my screen, because the dollars that you see here are not US dollars. They're those funny Canadian dollars, which are worth far less than the American counterpart. So if you are willing to spend, in my case, nearly $50 a year for the Google Plus, or for the Google Plus, for the Evernote Plus, you get access to your notebooks offline, you get unlimited devices, which is awesome, and you get the ability to forward your email to Evernote. You also get customer support via email, which I don't think is that big a deal. These two here, the additional ability to access your notebooks offline, and most importantly, the ability to email, forward emails into Evernote, are huge benefits and well worth the money, in my opinion. Having access to your notebooks offline means that you can be working on your computer on Evernote when you're on a flight somewhere, although many flights now have Wi-Fi, although it costs money to have Wi-Fi on flights or internet access on flights. But the but accessing your notes when you're offline, very valuable. And the ability to forward emails into Evernote is a boon. It's something that we use a lot. I use it every day. I use it to forward invoices and bills in so that I can keep proper track of all my accounting. And it's one of the hallmarks, that techniques that we teach in our Evernote Made Easy course, teaching people how to use Evernote. The ability to forward emails into Evernote is well worth the investment. Now, I actually purchased the premium version, and I do that for a couple of reasons. One is, my life, I rely on Evernote for everything organizationally in my life, so I don't want them to go away. So I just buy the premium version on principle, because this is a tool that I want to have around for a long time to come. I mean, we just have to look at the demise, even though it's still around, of a tool like Blab, which a lot of us were using for social sharing, for broadcast, but they didn't have a solid revenue model attached, and now they've stopped supporting the product, and it's gone away and not available to us. I don't want a tool like Evernote to ever go away, because I have so much of my life built into it, so I'm always going to want to support it financially. And actually, even though many of you may rail against this, I'm happy that they've raised the price. It shows that they're being fiscally responsible and they're building a business model that can continue. So I am actually a proponent of the price changes. I'm sure we'll get some interesting comments on YouTube about this. Now, what else do we get in the premium version while we're talking pricing? Beyond all of the things that you get in the first two versions, you get up to 10 gigabytes of data uploaded per month. And that is a bit of a non-issue for me. I've never, ever in my life come close to my headroom of the amount of data to upload to Evernote. Perhaps some of you have, but I never have. Additionally, now you've got some really more sophisticated features, the ability to annotate PDFs, to be able to do more search capabilities, and some really nice integration, which, for example, when you do searching in Google, it'll bring up your Evernote notes that have related content as well. So it's got some nice additional features there, as well as the ability to scan and digitize business cards, which a lot of people like. And they've also got a presentation module, which I've shown in the past in my course, but it's not something that I've ever used an awful lot. So for a few extra dollars a month, you get to the premium version, and you really don't have to worry. Every single feature within Evernote is going to be available to you. Now, before we leave this, since we are talking about Evernote and them changing the pricing, occasionally, even when they're not changing the price, they upgrade services and give us some more tools. One example is this here, the add passcode lock on all mobile apps. This was never available before. This was just released recently, and it was kind of an upgrade to the free version. And this is not the only tool that they've upgraded to the free version. A few, maybe it's a year ago now, they also allowed the free version to start to share notes, and they allowed us to start sharing and having discussion on notes, which used to be a premium service. So Evernote's watching very carefully what happens in the marketplace, and they're giving a lot of the main basic tools that people really need. They're making sure they're available in the basic version. So it's not always just about getting money. They're also concerned about their community. So kudos to them for adding this passcode lock. And let me show you how we get to that, because that is a nice security feature with our mobile devices. If you're choosing one of your devices to be a mobile, which I'm sure you're all going to do, adding this, going into your general settings and adding a passcode lock, means that you can add a second level of security to your smartphone over and above the passcode lock that's set into the smartphone. So if somebody gets into your phone, you can close off your Evernote notes and make them private with a 4-digit passcode here as well. And that's available in all of the plans now. So Evernote is not just taking things away, they are giving some things back as well. But the bottom line, it's going to cost a little bit more to use Evernote. It's going to be a little less convenient. convenient for those on the free plan. They're going to have to choose which devices very carefully they want to have Evernote applied to. And hopefully this is the beginning of a really bright future for Evernote, the fact that now they're going to have revenue to support ongoing development, ongoing growth, and ongoing support for its community. Well, I hope you found this video today to be useful. Now, there are three ways for you to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is please subscribe to this channel. Second is subscribe to our newsletter. Then you can hear about all of our upcoming live events and tutorials. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded channel supported by the generosity of you folks through the crowdfunding site Patreon. I encourage you to drop by our Patreon page, have a look, and discover what perks are involved in supporting Dotto Tech. And one of those perks is free access to Evernote Made Easy, our very popular course on using Evernote, so it might well be worth checking out, don't you think? That's it for today. Till next time, I am Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.